Good evening, everyone. Wynn Brown here with Haywood Healthcare's COVID-19 update for Monday, June 8th. Spectacular day out there. And I think we're going to run up some good weather, at least for the first part of this week. So get outside, get some exercise, physically distanced, of course, and enjoy the summer that is finally upon us. One of the things that we've been working on all day at Haywood Healthcare is responding and preparing for the phase two opening of the economy here in Massachusetts. There's a lot that affects businesses, but also affects the hospital, including the return to elective surgery. And so we are working hard to attest for that on Wednesday so that we are in compliance and right on time with all of that. I would encourage you, if you're coming to the hospital, just to remember to arrive on time if you're coming for an appointment. For the community members that are seeing this and patients with us, as our volume is picking up, especially on the Haywood campus, because we are only running on one entrance, Athol is running on two, that you just be prepared. You have a face mask with you and you answer your questions and get screened and you can move right along. We will be working on the ability for visitors to come to see our inpatients as well. Again, that has to do with PPE supply and a number of things. So just patience as we toggle to that. One of our challenges is staffing, especially we are understaffed right now in environmental services, which is housekeeping, security, and also door screeners. So we're working hard to get those staffed. If you are looking for a job, and or you have a college student who needs a job this summer, please check out our opportunities online. A couple more will be posted tomorrow, but we need door screeners, environmental services staff, and in some instances, if it's appropriate, security. So please take a look at that, and your patience is appreciated as we continue to adjust to the new normal, which, as you know, continually evolves. And if you're out in the community, as things open up, please maintain appropriate physical distancing, have your mask with you and wear it when you should be using it, and also hand hygiene. We have done a fantastic job in North Central Massachusetts and the North Quabbin region of getting the disease load down to a manageable level. And so we want to keep doing that. And as we open up to the public, we don't want to have a surge, which could then set everything back in the Commonwealth. Because as we earn these opportunities through the governor's order, they can also go back if the disease load and positive testing goes up. So let's keep doing our job, everybody. Good job so far. As we look at our testing, we have tested 5,806 individuals, 5,150 negative results, 493 positive. So you can see it's still creeping up. 72 indeterminates. That puts our cumulative positive rate at 8.6. So think about that. We were well double that back a month ago. The state cumulative rate is at 15.9%. But our 10-day rolling average is down to 2.11%. So 2.11, and the state is down to 5.27. So good work there on everybody's part. And if you do want to get tested, you can call and make an appointment. And whether or not you have signs or symptoms, if you just want to know, we will do that for you as well. You just have to have an appointment in addition to our surgical patients who are coming through for procedures and anybody with signs and symptoms. So take a look at that. There's also a graph that's going to be embedded with my email tonight, which shows you the bell curve of the death rate in the Commonwealth, and we peaked on April 24th, and you can see how we've come down nicely, and we just need to sustain that and keep that as low as possible. Inpatient-wise at Haywood, we have four positive patients that we are taking care of, three on Watkins 1, one in our ICU, and two patients under investigation, and we are awaiting their test results. A thank you today to the Williams Restaurant. They provided lunch today to pay the patient accounts team at Haywood, and that was because folks have been funding the gift card there, and we appreciate the community doing that at a number of dining establishments so that we can provide some support and some treats for our staff, so that as they're working very hard and under challenging circumstances, they know that the community appreciates them. So that really is my report tonight, brief and to the point. I'll get back to you tomorrow, and we'll let you know how everything's going as we ramp up for phase two. And if you have any questions, you can go to haywood.org, and we have a lot of the answers that you might be looking for right there. Have a great evening, everyone, and thank you as we continue our journey to be one of the best community-owned health systems in America.